Well, welcome to Father Adam's Kitchen. Bienvenidos todos a la cocina del Padre Adam. Aquí les voy a preparar unos nopales para que siempre no se me note el nopal, ¿no? ¿Verdad? Aquí tengo unos nopalitos para que siempre se me noten. So we always want to have the cactus showing, as it does always with me. And here I have the cactus already peeled, and I've chopped it like this, in these type of chunks. Aquí tengo, ¿no? El nopal ya, los nopales ya picados. Y aquí les voy a picar un poquito más, así los pico. Ok. Ahí. Y, a ver, los picamos. Así. Como de este tamaño, just like that, you know, just dice it like that. Meanwhile, have your pan be heating, so you can put some oil in there. Mientras tanto, tengan ustedes su sartén calentándose. Y le voy a añadir un poquito de aceite. Ahora, yo utilizo un aceite bien bueno para la salud. Para el corazón. So I use this really good algae oil, and it has 75% less saturated fat than olive oil. Okay, este es super bueno. Entonces pongo poquito, okay, en un sartén que está super caliente. Poquitito, just a little bit, okay, like that. Right, you don't need a lot. No ocupan mucha aceite. Okay, so this is a delicious cactus salad, and it's really good if you have diabetes. It's excellent, no, para que se te baje el azúcar. No hay nada mejor que los nopales. Y así, okay, ya voy a bajar la temperatura un poquito. I'm gonna lower the temperature a little bit, and put the cactus in there, all right, and it's gonna go for about 10 minutes, okay, unos 10 minutos se va a estar friando, okay. Okay. Now you want to coat all of the cactus with the oil. Okay. Los dejas cocinando unos 10 minutos. Okay. Y ahí lo voy a bajar un poquito más. Ok. Ahí. Se está cocinando ahorita, ¿no? Siempre le puedes añadir un poquito de agua para que no se te queme. Ok. Entonces, ahí. Un poquitillo. Ok. A little bit of water so that it doesn't burn. I don't use a lot of oil because each tablespoon of oil has 120 calories. Una cucharada de aceite tiene 120 calorías. Así que no utilicen mucho aceite. No ocupas utilizar tanto aceite porque de lo grasoso vas a salir mantecoso. Y eso es lo que quieres evitar. Mientras tanto, aquí tengo los otros ingredientes que voy a estar picando. El ajo. Okay, so we're using garlic. Garlic is a natural antibiotic. Es un antibiótico natural el ajo. Okay, entonces, the more garlic you can eat, the better. When I was growing up in Poland, whenever we were sick, my grandmother would always give us hot milk with a lot of garlic, and we'd have to take it. And to this very day, my grandmother, who's 85 years old, eats garlic every day, okay? Every single day. Because garlic is very, very good for you. All right, so, there we go. So, cut all your ingredients, and you wanna chop all the ingredients. While the cactus is cooking, mientras que los nopales están cocinando, I pica todos los ingredientes, okay? Now, you wanna chop this garlic fine, because you don't want, you do not want somebody to get a big piece of garlic, okay? So just chop it very finely. There's 5 cloves here. Hay 5
ajitos chiquitos. Okay. Ahí vamos. Okay, so chop it finely and then you... All right, so once you've chopped it, you can, I can just add the garlic to where I had the cactus. When I wait, okay, there we go. Okay, all right, next thing, you need the onions. So I just got one onion here, okay? Una cebolla le vas a poner. Aquí te estás picando mientras que tus nopales se te están cocinando. Hay le vas picando todos los ingredientes. ¿Ok? Así de este tamaño. ¿Ok? So not too small, not too big. Like that. ¿Ok? There we go. Be careful, don't cut yourself. Okay, no te cortes. All right, there we go. Cut all of our ingredients. Okay, there we go. So now, so this whole thing takes about 15 minutes and you have a nice cactus salad. And then you could put a couple of eggs in there if you want. It's not a problem. Put a couple of eggs in there and then you have protein and fiber and natural antibiotic, everything, okay? So I got some cilantro here. I'm gonna chop that at the end. But I'm putting in tomatoes, okay? These are Roma tomatoes. So again, you don't wanna chop this extremely fine. Okay, ahí vamos nosotros. No, me preparas todos los ingredientes. Así que todo eso para que vean ustedes que lo que yo aprendí en México, viviendo en México con mi gente chula mexicana. All of this so you can see all that I've learned while I lived in Mexico. And I'm sporting my wonderful 10th anniversary gift from the family that I lived with in Oaxaca. They sent me my present. And so I hope they're watching and they can see that I'm very, very grateful for their gift. Esta camisa me la mandó la familia de Oaxaca con la que me quedé cuando estaba yo viviendo todavía en México. Okay, entonces, so, ya ven ustedes, vamos a preparar una rica ensalada de nopales. Okay, so like that. Okay, there you go. Now, put this to the side and chop some cilantro. All right, now I've pre-washed all of this. All right, there we go. Aquí vamos a picar el cilantro para añadir después. Okay, ahí nos va. Yeah, okay. Voy a ver cómo están mis nopales. Siempre les puedes dar una probadita, ¿no? A los nopales para ver cómo se, si se están suavizando. Okay. Mmm, delicious. Okay. The heat needs to rise a little bit. There it is. And they're cooking. So now, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna have the water on high heat to evaporate a little bit. And this is the time for you to add a little bit of salt, okay? Just a little, okay? Not too much, just a little salt. There we go. And a little bit of pepper. Just a little bit. There we go. And there it is. Okay. And y ahorita también les voy a mostrar el ingrediente secreto. Okay. Ay. El chile. The chili peppers. You always have to have some chili in there. All right? So I'm gonna put just a little bit of these in there. Okay? Solo poquito, no mucho. All right, so chop them up. When these are dry, I just use the dry kind. That's okay, just for the flavor. All right, so it's only for the flavor. And because there is liquid in the nopales already, the liquid will soften them up. Okay, so there, okay? I just chop them up like that very finely. So, all right, get them nicely chopped. Vamos a ir. ¿No? Los picas y así los añades porque como tiene agua, como tienen agua ahorita, les puedes añadir estos secos chiles. Porque eso de que sean secos, ok. Ahí. Since there's some liquid in here, the liquid will soften up the chili peppers. You have to have spice in life. You know, the secret to Mexican cooking is a good chili. El secreto de una buena comida mexicana es el chile. Todos en Colombia quieren el chile, okay? Ya, se está quedando así el líquido, como ven, ya casi no hay líquido porque todo se está evaporando. So you want all of the liquid to evaporate, and it is. It's coming up, and it's fabulous. And so now I'm going to add the garlic. Ahí les va, voy a ponerle ajo. And give it a stir. Okay. Oh, there it is. And it's gonna cook right now. And the garlic is gonna give it that really, really good flavor. Life needs some flavor. We all need flavor in our life. And I told you that Jesus said we are the salt of the earth, but he also said that we are to be the light of the world. Now, light, you don't just turn on a lamp and you don't sit there and look at the lamp. No, the lamp illuminates something, like a room. It shines light on something. It illuminates. So we are, if we are to be the light of the world, that is the light of the people that we share our life with, we are to illuminate people, shine light on them, let them shine. Are you a person that shines light on the people in your life? ¿Estás iluminando tú la vida de los demás? Cristo dijo que nosotros somos la luz del mundo. No enciendes una luz y no la pones en un cuarto y no la ves a ella. La lámpara, cuando la enciendes, da luz a algo. O sea, deja que algo brille. Y si nosotros somos la luz del mundo, tenemos que dejar que a través de la luz que viene de nosotros, brille la luz de los demás. Que la luz de los demás, que nosotros iluminemos a los demás. Que seamos aquella luz que deja que otros brillen. Entonces tú eres la luz en la vida de tus familiares, de tu esposo, de tus hijos, de la gente en tu trabajo. Eres su luz. You know, are you a light that illuminates, that shines, that brightens? Brightens, that's the word. Do you brighten up people's days? That's what I try to do in
your life. I try to be that force in your life that brightens up your day. Okay, so now I added the onions. Okay, there we go. And how do you do that? You know, a lot of you don't know how to do that. You gotta go kinda like this, okay? ¿Cómo se hace esto? Nomás le haces así, pero si no sabes, no vas a tener la cocina llena con todas las cosas, así que es mejor utilizar la cuchara. Y ahí, le voy a poner un poquito de agua, okay, para que no se me queme. All right, and a little bit of water, okay, so that it doesn't burn, okay. So aquí tenemos la cebolla y aquí se nos está todo cocinando. And everything is cooking. So I always try to brighten up your day. Okay, even that you see that, you know, things like this. I have to learn how to cook for myself. One of the things that is the worst about living in the Western world is that we eat out all the time, particularly fast food. And you go to McDonald's and pretty soon you're gonna turn into a hamburger. And they're not just supersizing French fries and Cokes, but they're supersizing people. And it's extremely important for us to eat healthy. Healthy body, healthy mind. Healthy mind, healthy body. Psychosomatic. Soma means your body. Psyche is your mind. It's and spirit. It's a Greek word. Soma is also a Greek word because the English language has a lot of Greek in it. So Jesus said that our bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit. You have to care for your body. You have to care for your body. You have to eat healthy. And there is a correlation between healthy eating and healthy mind. That's why I always insist on that. And part of that is to cook for ourselves. Remember, what did Jesus do for the disciples? He cooked breakfast for them. Now, let me tell you something. Every time that we encounter Jesus before the resurrection. Before the resurrection, Jesus is always eating the food that somebody else prepared for him. Did you ever notice that? Somebody else cooked for him. And after the resurrection, what does Jesus do? Huh? He goes and he eats breakfast with them. He says, have you anything to eat? He says to the disciples. Because before that, he eats in people's homes. And he eats food that other people have prepared for him. But he also cooks for them. Remember, he cooked breakfast for them. At the Last Supper, he fed them. Right? But after the resurrection, he says, have you anything to eat here? What is he trying to say? Hey, listen, now it's your turn. It's your turn to do as I have done for you. You have to now cook for each other. And by cooking for one another, we show one another that we love each other. I mean, you know, anybody can invite you out to eat. Anybody can invite you out to eat. But if they cook a meal for you, now that takes effort, right? You know, anybody can take out a bill and pay in a restaurant, but if they've taken the effort, go out and get the ingredients and cook it with a lot of love. Nothing impresses me like somebody who will make a meal for you. Because that shows that they love you. That shows that they care. So it's one of the ways that you show your loved ones that you care for them, that you take the time to cook for them. No, una de las maneras en la que Cristo nos enseñó que nos ama es que cocinó el desayuno y otras comidas para sus discípulos, pero después de la resurrección, Cristo no les dijo, ¿no tienen algo ustedes aquí para comer? Y eso es en señal de que ahora es el trabajo de ustedes de alimentar a mi cuerpo. Y nosotros somos el cuerpo. Ahora ustedes tienen que hacer, somos el cuerpo de Cristo. Ahora ustedes tienen que hacer lo que yo he hecho, dice el Señor Jesús, ¿no? Y así como yo les he servido a ustedes, tienen que servirse unos a otros. Y cuando nosotros cocinamos a nuestros familiares, le cocinamos a Cristo. When you cook for your family members, you cook for Jesus. Whatsoever you do for other people, you do it for Jesus. Eso es lo que tenemos que aprender nosotros. Que todo lo que hacemos nosotros para otras personas, lo hacemos a Cristo. I can't love God whom I do not see if I don't love the people that I do see. That's why, you know, the Bible says if you hate other people, if you harbor ill feelings towards other people, if you have resentment in your heart, but then you say, I love God, you're a liar. You love God by loving other people. It's very clear in the Bible. Very clear in the Bible. ¿Cómo amamos a Dios? Amándonos unos a otros. Ámense unos a otros como yo los he amado. You want to love God? You got to love people. Yeah, and all the people. Even the inconvenient people. It's not easy. You know, it's not easy for you to cook for your family every single day. Not easy, you know. I mean, it's easy to behave well at work because they pay you over there. But at home, it's a different story, right? Well, that's where your vocation comes in. Esa es la vocación de nosotros. Mi vocación es servir a ustedes, ser sacerdote para ustedes. Por eso les hice tamales, les hice tortillas, les hice virtuales, obviamente, no, les hice salsa y ahora les estoy haciendo nopales. So you cook this by adding a bit of water, okay? You just go adding water. All right, now I'm gonna lower the heat, okay, and add the tomatoes, okay? Los jitomates. Ahora pones los jitomates, okay? And that, you don't cook that for too long. Y eso es lo que nos enseñó nuestro Señor Jesucristo. De que el amor se demuestra. De nada me sirve si yo les dijera a ustedes, oh, los amo bien mucho. Ustedes lo tienen que percibir a través de mis acciones, ¿no? Ustedes lo tienen que sentir. El amor se siente, no de la boca. Obviamente es importante decir, ¿no? Ah, yo te amo, te quiero. No, eres sumamente importante para mí. Eso es, sí es importante decir, pero el amor se siente, tu familia lo tiene que sentir. Your family has to feel that you love them. They have to feel it. And it's what we do for one another, not what you buy for other people. So, and part of that is that we cook healthy meals for one another. Now, when I moved to this country, my parents never had time to cook. Never. My mom was working 2-3 jobs. And so I ate out all the time. She'd give me $5 and there, go. Go get yourself McDonald's. It's part of the reason why I got so big. Yes. And cheap food is unhealthy food. That's why it's a lot of times very inexpensive to eat very bad food.
canned food with a lot of sodium in it. That's why we have to cook for one another.
No, una de las maneras que yo subí tanto de peso en este país era porque mi mamá nunca tuvo tiempo para cocinar. Nomás me daban $5 y ay, vete a comprar, ¿no? La comida chatarra. Y eso es lo que me dañó a mí tanto. Porque nunca tenía tiempo. ¿Cuántos de ustedes comen a la carrera?
How many of you eat very fast, on the go? On the go, you never have time, not even to eat. Eating is so very important. The table in the house is sacred. La mesa en la casa es sagrada. Tu mesa es sagrada. You sit down with your family and you eat. You sit down with your spouse and you eat. And not speaking on your phones. Put the phone down and turn it off. And sit down and eat. Apaguen sus celulares. Apaguen el chisme book. Y convivan. Hijos, ¿cómo les ha ido en su día? ¿Ah? ¿Cómo les ha ido a ustedes? ¿Cómo les ha ido? Ahí hablen. Okay, so now I'm going to try this. I have a spoon here that's a little better. Okay, I'm going to try it and see how it is when it comes to salt. Okay? Let's see. I think I have a spoon over here. Okay. Let me see. Pica. Era suficiente chile. That was enough of the chilies. It's delicious. And now the cilantro. Just the right amount of salt and pepper and chili. I'm glad I didn't put any more chilies in there because that would not have been good. Okay. Era suficiente chile. Y ahora nomás le dejas que... Okay, you don't want that. No quieres esto. Okay? Y ahí. La ensalada. And this is so delicious and extremely healthy. Extremely healthy food. No? Very low carb. What was the one thing that I had to avoid is eating very simple carbohydrates. You gotta eat, you have to eat complex carbohydrates with a lot of fiber. Okay. Nothing better than cactus. No hay nada mejor que los nopales. Ahí. Yeah, okay. Ahí está. Ahora, déjenme, les voy a mostrar. Okay. Now you can see the finished product, my cactus, okay? So that was raw cactus, and you can get it at the Mexican store or go out and cut some. That's what I do. Around here, there's a lot of cactuses. Yeah, and then, you know, you have to take out the spines. Yo sí me pelo mis propios nopales. Voy y los corto en la sierra aquí. Aquí tenemos bien muchos nopales. It's very healthy. No, bien saludable y bien barato. Solo que sí requiere que te pongas a hacerlos. Okay. Wow. That is good. That is really, really good. It's good for your digestive system. I mean, the chili is a very good thing. You don't eat a lot. If you eat more spicy, you won't eat so much. Okay? It's one of the tricks. Si comes picoso, ya no vas a comer tanto. Y toma mucha agua. Okay? No soda. Don't drink soda. Father, what did you do? So many people ask. Stop drinking soda. Oh, but I drink diet. It's even worse.
Even worse, artificial stuff, not natural. The bubbles go into your stomach and they expand and it makes you feel even more hungry. So the more diet stuff you drink, the more food you're gonna consume. Have you heard of water? ¿Han escuchado de agua? A veces yo voy a unas casas, ¿no? Y los niños, pura soda. ¿Por qué no les dan agua?
Es que no quieren. Van a llorar.
¿Y que lloran sangre?
Oh, my kids don't want to drink water. They just want soda. And if I don't give it to them, they cry.
What do they cry? Blood? I mean, come on. Who's in charge of the household? You are. Your children need to eat healthy food. The rates of diabetes in children is unreal, particularly in our Hispanic community. No. ¿Cuántos niños nuestros latinos con diabetes? ¿Qué les pasa? Por darle soda. Por no alimentarlos. Esos son los resultados. De pésame, señor. ¿Ah? Está riquísimo. It's absolutely delicious. Absolutely delicious. It's like the best food. Really. Now, one thing I do a lot of times is I'll put a couple of eggs in there. And that, it tastes really good. So, I'm going to take out this right now. Okay. Like that. I'm going to take this out and just leave maybe this much. Okay. And to this much, I would add one egg. Okay. Like that. And that will give you a lot of protein if you add an egg. So, let me get an egg. Aquí traigo. Ya. Acá está. No, aquí tengo. No, tenía yo un huevo ya preparado. Okay, y aquí tengo mi huevo. Nomás uno. No. No voy a poner dos, nomás un huevo, ¿ok? Just one egg, ¿ok? Ustedes, yo sé que a algunos a lo mejor les faltan más huevos que para comer, obviamente, ¿no? Para comer, que a otros, entonces pónganse dos, ¿ok? A ver, que se prenda. Ahí está, ya, ya se prendió. Ah, ¿ok? There. And you want that to heat up a little bit. And again, you don't need to put any oil in there, okay? Stop cooking with so much fat. You don't need it. We're in love with fat. We're in love with carbohydrates. We're in love with all that stuff. No ocupas usar tanto aceite. No, estamos nosotros enamorados de grasa. ¿Eh? Yo sé que ustedes dicen, ay, padre, es que la gordura es pura sabrosura. Stop it, okay? You have to get healthy, okay? Now, especially if you're at home, get busy doing things like cooking, trying new recipes. Yeah, okay? So here, I just put an egg in there. Just crack it. Like that, perfect. Okay, now, and I don't add anything else in, just one egg, and I let it cook, let it fry up, and that gives you a lot of protein. Eggs are wonderful. They have a lot of protein. No, los huevos son super buenos, tienen mucha proteína. Okay, and there, that's a perfect lunch right here. Okay, y aquí está. Un lunch perfecto, ¿no? And if you make a homemade tortilla like I did the other time, you have a nice lunch. Yeah, I'm gonna try that one. Okay. Just to let you see. Y aquí tienes un lunch delicioso. Very good lunch, inexpensive, nutritious. Even better. Now, how much chili to put in? Well, it's up to you how spicy you want it. I just put in how much I want. You know, the spices depend on how you like it. You gotta kind of play around with the recipes. Mmm. Delicioso. Mm. Que Dios me los bendiga.